All right, we're coming up with the sponsor AV in just a bit, but right now, ladies and gentlemen, let's kickstart the event. It's a very exciting day. And, you know, to kickstart, who else but a man we all adore? Now, we're going to talk about him. He is a man who wears so many hats. Tell us more about it.
You know, we have to, you know, start this event by welcoming the media mogul, the co-founder of India's largest music business community. And you know, he's lost like 10 kilos in the last week.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's a charmer. He is, if I have to look at him, if I forget his name, I'd call him Vin Diesel. Please give a big round of applause and welcome the one, the only, Anurag Batra. Good
morning. Morning. First, my apologies for starting late, but sometimes good things take time. Good music takes time. So really, we've got the show on the road, and let's give a big round of applause to Sushant and Rehman. I do remember your names. Please give them a big round of applause. And let me tell you a secret. There are secret cameras in the room. You only get food, liquor, goodies, and time with speakers and celebrities if you clap. They record that, and we have a technology that syncs it. So can you clap for them? Louder. It's loudest dot it. Second, let me tell you, clapping has three benefits. One, it relaxes your heart muscles, so it's good for health. Second, someday you'll be up here, you'll need the applause, so fill in your karmic bank. And third, the government has not yet taxed clapping. The way they're going, they may tax clapping because they may make money from it. I normally don't make PowerPoint presentations because they're made by people who are neither powerful nor have a point of view. I'm Neeraj Roy's friend, so definitely I can claim to be powerful and have a point of view. First of all, I'd like to welcome all the friends from the media, music, entertainment, communication, marketing, advertising domain, especially our keynote speaker, Mr. Neeraj Roy, who's a pioneer in the digital music entertainment space. My friend Lloyd Mathias, who's been part of our journey for the last 18 years. My lawyer and friend Sudhir Mishra, who does a lot of work in the entertainment domain. Sudhir's colleague Petal, who works on our account. But this conference has been put together by, it's customary to thank your colleagues, your partners at the end. I'd start with that because ours is a people business and people matter. I'd like to thank Aparajita, who's really curated this conference. You all, most of you know Aparajita. She was here. I don't know where she is now. Please give her a big round of applause. Rushaki. Rushaki is the one with the red hair. When I grow up, I want to be like her. May not grow up. That's another story. I just want to tell you that when I stand here amongst stalwarts of music, musicians from the ecosystem, I have the same dilemma that the seven husbands of Elizabeth Taylor faced on the night of the honeymoon. Do you know what the dilemma was? Do you know the dilemma or you don't know the dilemma? Pooja Mishra knows everything, right? Though I don't watch Big Boss, but the dilemma that the seventh husband of Elizabeth Taylor faced on the night of the honeymoon was, he told Elizabeth Taylor, "The darling, I know what I'm supposed to do, but I hope I make it interesting." So I was small. See, Music Inc. and Loudest is a platform for music, musicians, and business. It's where music meets technology. It's where music meets investors. It's where music meets people who give them business. It's where music meets brands, because sonic branding. So it's about the business of music. But you cannot talk about business of music without musicians, without people who create music. So it's a platform that brings, loudest.in is our editorial platform. We have a lineage of doing marquee editorial products. For those of you who don't know me and what we do, I started a company called Exchange for Media 18 plus years back. It's the number one advertising marketing media website. We have a weekly called Impact. We have a monthly called Pitch. Then 5 years back, I acquired India's number one business magazine called Business World. So we have a locus standi of doing editorial products. We build communities. We are not in the business of magazines, websites, events. We are in the business of building communities. So this is our music community. And over the next 2 days, you'll make meaningful connections, you'll create soul connections, you'll create heart connections, and you'll also create business connections. So just to contextualize this conference, I have a presentation. Do you have my presentation? Hello, the gentleman at console, are you sleeping? Do you have my presentation? Very good. I sent it, I was awake till 4 a.m., made it, but So I will talk to you. Praveen, can you get the presentation to him somehow? I'll talk to you. One is Apple versus Spotify. I had a beautiful graphic which showed the progress, but really Apple was the first mover, Spotify came in later, but Apple and Spotify is an interesting contest. Last year in 2018, Spotify was king of the hill, which was at 83 million paid subscribers, and it is crossing 100 million, and Apple Music was at 57 million. They've both grown significantly, so the battle between them will grow. In India also, Spotify, which is the leader globally, came late but already notched up a significant base in a very short time. And Amarjeet Batra of Spotify will be here to talk about it. Now, in no business, you can not talk of the Chinese. The Tencent Music is making a move. And Tencent Music had an IPO. They're cash rich. And the Chinese play a big game and a long game. Who knows, Chinese may acquire a Spotify or other business. One of the things that is happening is the smart speaker growth. And the smart speaker growth is a boon for musicians. It's currently kind to Amazon Music because there was a big holiday of eco sale and there were a boost in Prime membership. So the smart speaker growth is really creating for musicians and music players a new outlet. We've grown up on charts. I want to say that the charts will mean less and less. Billboard has ruled the music world for more than 50 years, and its charts have been the Bible for artists and labels everywhere. In 2019, that has ceased because charts have become lesser relevant, and playlists, especially from the major streaming services, have gained more influence. Major labels may lose their mojo in 2019. In my slide, it says, small is beautiful, new is stronger. Once the dream of every artist, today artists is more likely to shun a major to go it independently, since many of the benefits of a major can be had without actually signing to one. Indie and boutique labels continue to grow both in numbers and revenue, and artists thrive in a more do-it-yourself world. Streaming services remain unprofitable, but they will become the major dominant force in every part of the ecosystem. Choked by the weight of label licensing deals, these platforms struggle to find a way to become profitable, leading to a major market consolidation that I expect to happen by the end of the year. Now, most of you heard of the Article 13. Article 13 came out from an EU ruling which holds streaming platforms responsible for the files their users upload. Now, it's created a YouTube chaos, with YouTube and other streaming platforms having to publish so many videos, artists and labels take a big hit in revenue, but even worse in exposure as well. I know Facebook is our partner and it's a great company and we are very happy to partner, but let me say, as 2019 progresses, artists use social media for promotions even lesser. Many artists have relied on social media as a method of both growing and engaging their fan bases, but that is changing big time in 2019 because that's the only way to large-scale engagement comes from paid promotion on the various social platforms. So artists who are starting out may or may not do that. Many artists drop off because of principle, even more because of the cost. Instagram carries the load, at least for a while, until it focuses more on revenue that users. I know. Thank you so much. We got it. Can you get to my slide? Can I get the presentation? Now, when we talk of streaming changes song structures even more. In a short, now the song length will be next to a short duration because it is profitable to have a fan listen twice instead of to one longer song. So the implication is smaller songs. Last but not the least, you cannot talk of the music business without talking of TikTok. Mr. Puri, thank you. Mr. Puri is a musician, he charms. He's the general manager of the hotel, but so TikTok is becoming bigger and bigger. The growth in TikTok globally has majorly come from India in the last 1 year. TikTok has added 86 million plus users from India. And TikTok has realized that there are lots of good singers. Lots of it is rubbish. So they're launching an influencer service. So they believe that they can create artists. So TikTok is changing the way the music business is coming up. I wanted to say, since we are amongst musicians and we are among music creators and leaders like Neeraj and Lloyd and Sudhir, who's I've already gone through it. I want to talk about only two things and sit back. One, I want to talk about the fact that we exist as loudest not only to be profitable, sustainable, which we are not yet. We will be someday, but that's okay. We are here to improve the ilk of musicians, help them make more money, connect them to investors, brands, technology. Second, because there's lots of musicians, at least 10, 12 I met already, I want you to promote responsible lyrics. I mean, I did invite Honey or Yo-Yo Singh, he hasn't come. In some way, I'm glad. But that's not the kind of lyrics I want to promote. Responsible lyrics. I know in today's world of TikTok, responsibility is not a good word. But this is what I've done, it doesn't work. You know, we do a conference a day and everything works, but I guess this is a new conference. And so I said, I think music in itself is healing. It's an explosive expression of humanity. It's something we are all touched by. No matter what culture we are from, everyone loves music. And these were the 12 music trends, and this is the slide I wanted to show you. Spotify was the leader, Apple Music came later, but Apple Music, Apple in every business is really, you know, they have an advantage of cash, they have an advantage of understanding the user, and I talked about Tencent versus music, and I want to end by, in Sonic branding I talked about, we have a workshop. So we, two objectives of loudest in Music Inc. are improve the earnings and life of musicians and promote responsible. And really, if I had to leave you with a message, implications for musicians is reinvent 360 degree. I would say that Music Inc. is a two-day MBA in music. If you're a musician, you're here, you meet people like Neeraj, Lloyd, you will know. I want to end by saying, if music is a place, then jazz is the city, folk is the wilderness, rock is the road, and classical is a temple. I wish you 2 days of melody, learning, and business. And if you want to connect with me, bring melody, music, and moolah together, you can reach out to me at anuragbatrayo@gmail.com. That's anuragbatrayo, and that's my Twitter handle. Thank you. God bless you. Over to Rehman and Shushan. Thank you. God bless you.